Thank you all for making the effort to come here, especially with broken legs. Appreciate the effort. I'm John, most people know who I am. At the beginning of last season, all the coaches got to introduce themselves, apart from me. So I thought I'd take this opportunity just to introduce myself to the team. It's been a year with me already. I'm from Scotland. I'm from Ayrshire. I'm from Ayrshire. Same neck of the woods as Tish. But I'm from South Ayrshire, he's from North Ayrshire. If you watch Game of Thrones, I'm from King's Landing. So I got into American football when I went to university because the rugby guys, no thanks, Ben. I liked game and then realised that it got played in the UK, and so I thought, let's give it a try. So I did the full pre-season, and then the last training session before my first game, I broke my ankle, and that was done. But I came back next year, and that year, amazingly, we actually won the college bowl. So it was a bit, and it was with Stirling Clansmen, nothing like what they are now. It was proper ragtag stuff, player coaches, you know, no money, no investment. We just had a. For some reason, we just had a healthy bunch of players that came along. And so that was a really good start. Once I graduated, I played for East Kilbride Pirates. The previous year, had just been to the Brit Bowl, so they had a good team. But they just kicked out somebody who was a bit of a troublemaker, and a few players left in protest. The first kind of couple of years, slowly but surely, the players were leaving the team, so it was a bit in the downward spiral. So there was maybe 20, 25 players, but sometimes not unfamiliar problem. And then in 2006, about 7 or 8 really talented young guys, nearly, came through, and really helped the team come through, and we had. It was a really good core, which if you've been following the game for a few years now, then you'll know that EKP have had a good run in the last 4 or 5 years. So we were quite a good team. We got to the quarterfinals and played in the last season with them. We played the Blitz and ran them close, so they went on to win the Brit Bowl that year. I then moved down to London to pursue a career in marketing and joined the Blitz, and they were on their way to rolling to what they were good to become then, but it was a fantastic experience because you had a collection of really some of the best players in the UK at that time, and you had gone from scores of 25 to 30 guys to some seasons we had like 60, 70 guys on the sideline, it was nuts. I played with them for 3 years, took a season out and came back. But in those 3 years, everything you could hope to achieve, at club level, played the Brit Bowl finals, lost first one. We led the whole game in the last 3 seconds. Coventry got that field goal. But you've got to take it off with the smooth. We won the next two Brit Bowls after that. Also got to play in Europe, again, fantastic. So Berlin, Amsterdam, Paris, a real privilege to be part of them. And also from 2006 to 2010, I was part of a GB setup as well. So I was involved in that. And I had a mixed experience, to be honest. It was fantastic to be in such structured and well-managed training sessions, really tough two-day sessions, film in between, the weekend camps. It really developed me as a player, taught me how to properly read a playbook and really understand what else was going on within the offense, because the position it was playing in was a bit of a hybrid, kind of running back, tight end, H-back kind of role. So you really needed to know your stuff, and it was quite an education to be part of, you know, what was, you know, effectively the closest thing to a professional setup that you could play in the UK. So that was good. But I was always in the fringes of the squad. I wasn't one of the best athletes, you know, I wasn't really getting on. I was on special teams a little bit, you know, I wasn't really shining in training. And all throughout my time as a player, my fitness levels were up and down, just because natural pressures of life, not understanding the right things, you know, I should be doing, you know, not training as hard as I could, you know, and I got caught out when they did some testing about halfway through my time with GB, and that sort of tainted the coach's opinion of me in my head. So I was still with the squad, but, you know, clearly I've let myself down. And then, so I was with GB for these 4 years, you know, went to every camp, and then just before the European Championships, which is what we'd all been building up to, the cut from the squad. And it wasn't anything other than me as a player not fulfilling my potential. I know that if I had been in sync with the training and worked harder and knew what I was supposed to be doing, I would have been talented enough to make the squad. So I don't, you know, hold any ill will against coaches or whatever. They've got to make a decision, they've got to cut the squad. Down, but that was my experience there. So kind of missed opportunities, I would say, to kind of finish off a career at a high level. So why have we brought you here today? And why have we created this player development program? In June I read an article on Double Coverage of all places. It was a pretty good one, actually. And it was talking about performance teams versus participation teams, and what is right and what is kind of wrong. What's the right approach and what's the wrong approach? Because, you know, we are amateurs. We're not paid to do this. We want to play because it's fun. But we've also got guys that want to play and take it seriously and want to win, you know. So I took a view on it, and I kind of thought to myself, well, what are we at Boost Valley? Are we a participation club, or are we a performance club? You know, and so I've put down here, I'm not going to read it out, but my sort of interpretations of what one club is and what, you know, what a participation club is and what a performance club is. But I didn't know, so I asked Nelly, what are we as a club? You know, are we participation or are we performance? So he gave me a slide. And, you know, in that, he explained to me that our goal as a club is to strive to be the best team in the country. So we're up there with Tamworth, with the Blitz, with the Warriors. That's the goal for this club. And how are we going to achieve that? So there's three things here. There's the increased awareness of the sport and Boost Valley football. So Billy, the committee, and all of us take responsibility in that. You know, we're sharing the Facebook events, we're going to these sessions, you know, to attract people to the game. We're getting friends to come along. You know, that's a shared responsibility that we're all involved with. And, you know, Billy and the committee, and we work on that. But skip to the third one. And another goal is to develop our coaches. And Nelly is doing a fantastic job of doing that with our coaches. So we've set up sessions with, you know, independent people to help us get in the right frame of mind. He's, you know, got our own coaches forum, and he's sharing really good information. And in the background, he's kind of creating a structure for us to empower us to be better coaches. And he's putting pressure on us to be better coaches. So we've got that covered. What about developing the players? Because in my eyes, you guys are special. You're special because you're players that are committed to coming to this club and to playing out a full season. You'll get guys that will come, you saw the numbers we had in January, and then you saw the numbers we have in the end of the season. There's only certain type of person that is willing to commit themselves physically and mentally and for the amount of time that it takes to be part of this team. So you're all special. So you, in effect, are our strongest resource for the club and the key to for us to becoming the best in the country. So, what are we going to do to make you the best you can be? And that's what the PPP is all about. And it's open to everyone that's associated with the club. And it focuses on the four key areas that I believe are what makes up a talented player. So you've got the strength and conditioning, you've got your football education, your mind, you know, how well you know the game on the field so that you can make the best decision and react to a situation that happens. Diet and nutrition, so it's a 50-50 split in terms of your body, your physical development between diet and nutrition and strength and conditioning. And then you've got to have consistent measuring, because whenever, in anything in life, you've got to, if you're aiming to achieve something, you've got to know where you are to begin with. And then you've got to know where you want to be, and you've got to understand how you're going to get there. And that's what the measurement part of the program is all about. So, what we're going to do is we're going to hear from, first of all, Fab, who's heading up the strength and conditioning side of PDP. We're then going to hear from Nell, who's going to talk about the education stuff. Then Ben, as keynote speaker, is going to come in and speak about diet and nutrition. I will talk about how diet nutrition plays into the PDP's program, but one of the things is getting speakers like Ben on here to educate you guys, to making sure you understand what you need to do to be the best athlete you can be. And then I'll talk about measuring, and then finish off with just some of the other features and the pricing and, you know, how the whole thing comes together at the end. All right.